semi-final, Durham University versus Newcastle University. My name's Jonathan Rooney, I'll be commentating tonight. And with me, a last-minute replacement, but he's gonna help us out with the basketball knowledge. It's Connor Joyce, joining us from Newcastle University.
Yeah, pulled straight in. Yeah, with the crowd into the fire.
Yeah, it's looking good. What do you make of the team so far?
Looking quite good. They've been quite good shooting. The taller guys and the centres and power forwards in Newcastle look like they've got some range. Durham would be much more focused on near the basket kind of shots.
Yeah, I mean, that's been the season so far. Durham have had an excellent season. Number one seed in their conference. Convincing quarter final against Huey last week. Bit of a small ball approach, but you know, a team that works extremely hard, hustles, ultimately makes its shots. Last week against Huey, Chris Jones, point guard, didn't miss. 19 points, 11 rebounds, 11
yeah,
assists.
Yeah, I was thinking that going in. All the guards for Durham have been quite good close to the rim. They've been able to switch hands in mid-air, and like, it's got a nice flow to their jumpers.
Yeah, absolutely. Durham will quite often get behind the play of Massey Williams. He's the leading scorer on the team with 20 points per game. He's currently just on the bench, last moments of preparation. Who catches your eye for the Newcastle team?
I quite like the guy going to the basket now, the one that's just slammed at home.
Okay.
He's looked very good from deep. He's shot a few good jumpers from the elbow, and
yeah,
obviously been, as we can see, attacking the rim really well.
Yeah, absolutely.
Number 10, he's been flying about pre-game as well.
Yeah.
He's really just been going for the showboat dunks, trying to get the crowd going, I suppose.
What's really interesting about Newcastle is they have, you know, about 10 players who are going to play a lot of time today, and they're really going to rotate round. It looks like our actual second commentator is here to save Connor's.
You got me for 5 minutes.
Give her a minute or two to prepare. Oh no, we're doing an immediate switch. So bear with us a moment.
I'm just saving time. I have to get out of the way.
Wow.
So welcome in Betsy McDonald to the booth.
Hi.
A touch later than we hoped, but we're here now.
Yep, sorry about that.
How are you feeling?
I'm feeling so excited right now. And walking in here just got me more excited, seeing all these people who came out to support.
Yeah, the arena looks great, doesn't it?
It really does. I love it.
Wow. And I see you got quite a bit of support here. I thought all the support would be here for the boys, but no, apparently number one fan.
Exactly. Yep, some of my own teammates came out to support me supporting them, so
yeah.
It'll be fun.
Well, you're famous now.
Eh? Exactly.
So just talking with Connor there about the two teams, about Durham's, you know, real sort of great shooting, great hustle, great hard work, you know, a bit of a small ball approach. Newcastle, they play 10 players, like they rotate through the squad. You've got some big dudes, they've got some fast dudes, they can change what they're going to do. Did you see any of the previous matchups with these two?
I did. I saw the last time that these two teams played at home, and Durham took care of business, and it was not a close game at all. Although I did hear that some of Newcastle's players were missing, so...
Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to put up on screen the teams first, and we're going to go with the home team first with Durham University. We're going to have a look at these teams and see exactly who is going to be playing tonight. So as you can see, the Durham on screen, the starting lineup is number 4, Winkowski, number 5, Maxwell, big number 8, Massey Williams, number 9, Tanner Finley, number 11, Chris Jones. We expect to see number 13, Stanojevic, off the bench fairly early.
Mm-hmm.
Plays a big part in the team as the sixth man. Who are you going to be watching tonight?
I think for Durham, it definitely starts with Chris
yeah.
Jones. He's their leader. I think he's a coach who's on the court. He runs the point. He's directing the team at all times, and He actually like was their coach last year, so I think he's really just an extension of Ian on the court. He keeps them poised, he controls the tempo, and I think he's the key to the game.
Yeah, he's coming off a great game against UMe, quarterfinals, 19 points, 11 assists. He didn't miss. His shooting efficiency was 105%.
Oh my goodness.
Someone had to explain to me before the game, because I was like, okay, that doesn't check out. Like, no, the threes count more. And you know, all season he's been consistent. 12 points per game, 7 assists, 6 rebounds.
Yep.
His production's off the chart, really. And I have a quick look at the Newcastle team, and okay, we know a little bit less about the Newcastle team. And as we said, there's probably going to be 10 players playing quite a lot today. I think that the leaders in minutes are going to be number 4, Badu, number 7, Hobart, number 9, Labossiere, number 12, Joe Schiavelli, and Nico Early as well.
Mm-hmm.
I think the Irish team that mixes it up, we're going to see Matthew Tomlinson, we're going to see Ian MacDonald. We can always tell when Ian MacDonald's on the court, very very slim but very tall.
Yep.
Likes a bit of a showtime dunk, so it's quite an exciting team, and they flex between absolutely massive players
and
a lot of smaller, fast players. Is it more difficult to play against a team like that? Do you get knocked out of a rhythm?
I think this works out in Durham's favor. You know, because Durham has some small guards as well. But I think in the post, I think Sue will be able to win the post battle between their bigs and him.
And you just see now on the court, they're calling out the players, announcing. Newcastle do have a bigger squad, a few extra players. Be interested to see how they utilise them, how coach Mark Elderkin gets them in and off the course. And of course, our coach Ian Hewitt has recently come across from Newcastle, so there's a little bit of extra
Definitely.
You might be able to hear in the background our announcer is just talking. Don't worry, the screen hasn't gone off, the lights on. Durham have made an incredible 11 finalists so far, hoping to have the 12th tonight. I'm rooting for 13th on Sunday with American football.
Yes.
One of the best years in Durham. Of course, your squad's got a big final on Sunday as well, up in Glasgow.
Yeah, big trophy final for the WBBL, which we're excited about. That's good to hear that Durham is doing so well.
Lightning fast start.
Yep, definitely. I think Durham's gonna jump on them right away.
How important in a game like this is it to make that first shot and get that lead and always be ahead?
Oh, that's always so important. The start of the game, you want to get out on the team right away, set the tone for the entire game. And I think if Durham can get a quick start, it'll be tough for Newcastle to dig their way back in. And I should also mention that Sue, Admasu, number 8, I think he'll be super important this game for Durham.
Yeah, well, he's been the leading scorer on the season. He's averaging 20.2.
Yeah.
And, you know, they're big numbers in this league.
Yep.
10-minute quarters. Game's going to be over in the blink of an eye to average 20 throughout the
season.
Right.
Yep.
Not only did it go, when you fixed it, your face was on live stream. Big time.
It was.
Real close up. Well, sorry, a couple of technical issues there, but we're just ironing out a few wrinkles. Looks like we're back streaming live, and we're just a few minutes away from tip. If I had to push you, Durham by how many?
I'm going to say, you know what? I'm going to say it's going to be closer than last game. I'm going to say Durham by 12.
Durham by 12.
Yep. Okay. So what do you have? What do you have?
I wouldn't profess to be enough of an expert. I mean, they handled University of West England, who came here with a big squad, big athletes, looked big, looked scary in warm-ups, you know. But Durham set about them really aggressively, really physically. Another performance like that, and I can see Durham being fairly comfortable.
Yep.
So it looks like the starting five for Durham is as we expected. Newcastle, I've also lined up. Okay, Matthew Tomlinson's got the start at 30. Good to see an undergrad getting a start, to be honest. It's been quite a postgraduate dominated league. But Matthew Tomlinson looks like he might be able to play for quite a while. It's quite interesting to see the college as Colmar's sixth form.
Say it again.
It's interesting to see the college as...
Oh, yeah, that is.
Some great schools represented out there tonight on both sides. And it's really nice to see an undergraduate on the court.
Definitely. Nice. Good start. Durham gets the tip. That's a good start.
Win those small battles early.
Definitely. I love starting the game on offense, too.
It lets you set the tone. How fast do we think these teams are going to play?
I think Durham likes to play fast. They like to play an up-tempo game. And I think Newcastle's similar. First shot by Joel. Yes!
Start. Open shot.
There it is.
Joel Winkowski knocks it down. 3-0 lead.
Yep, and Durham started picking up full court too, which means I think they want to play a fast-paced game.
Yeah, and actually Newcastle responded with quite some pace here. Good movement. Moving the ball around well.
Yep.
Starting with a good
going inside.
In a bit of shot clock trouble here, but great rebound for Massey.
Yep.
Dominant board.
Nice.
And that's easy in transition.
Yep.
5-0 Durham.
That is Chris's game right there. When he gets it in transition, he just knows how to make the right decision.
You've got to feel is if this game goes with a lot of high number of possessions, it's Durham's. Like the shooting this year has been superb.
Yep.
So I guess if it comes to the more shots we take,
definitely,
we'll definitely make more.
Yep.
That's good play.
Yep,
come back after the hard drive last time where he didn't get much. He's done really well there.
Yeah, that was a nice take.
It's Nico Early. Okay, with the early 2 points for Newcastle. We're here 5-2. Durham calmly moving the board around, calling for screens, getting open looks.
Yeah, I think a big reason for their... Oh, good shot. Oh, good rebound.
Winkowski started amazing.
There we go.
I messy period of play there, and Newcastle get control of the ball and they bring it out to Hobart. Newcastle team's big on number 7, Tom Hobart.
Okay. One of their main guards.
Very, very smooth player.
Oh, good block by Tanner.
Tanner, yeah. Tanner's work rate in the quarterfinals is incredible. Nice. Great steal there. David Labossiere there. He even checked with the referee. So yeah. He wasn't sure.
Right, right.
5-4 here at Lady Castle.
I was going to say, I think a big reason why Durham is able to shoot so well is their passing. They move the ball so well. It's like, it's really hard to defend.
You know, as a layperson to the game, it seems very smooth is what I say.
Definitely, yeah.
There's no panic.
Yep.
The shots look open.
Definitely. Great pass right there. Nice. Beautiful. That was a great pass. Great finish.
It's been interesting. So three drives so far, yep. All three have gone through Nico early.
Yeah.
They're going to try and work that power game early, it looks.
Right. All their points have been in the paint, in the lane. So I think Durham might have to take a look at that.
You've got an Imperial March from Star Wars going. It's looking real serious.
Definitely. Oh, good take. There we go.
Okay, so for viewers who may be checking in, people's parents, what is the foul situation in this league? Like, what are we dealing with here?
So that's a shooting foul.
Because
so
he was in the process
of
shooting.
Yep, so he'll get two shots since he didn't make it.
And in terms of, like, team fouls and going to the line, how many is it in this league?
Okay, so for men, it's different than women.
Oh, no.
So I got to double-check my facts, but okay. I think it's... 6 fouls, 7 fouls, you shoot 1-1, which means you get one shot. If you make it, you get another shot.
Mm-hmm.
And then at 10 team fouls, you get 2 shots.
Okay.
Nice. Good shot,
Sue. Nice way to recover there. So we're 8-6, about halfway through the first quarter. Newcastle looking good, but just looking a little bit more edgy, a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Faster, a little bit more tension in the play. Durham looking super smooth, but it's still close.
Definitely.
You know, is points off turnovers a big statistic with
the
basketball?
Oh, definitely, yep.
That steal at the minute is making it a close game.
Yeah. Yep, transition points are huge in basketball. Good take. Oh.
It's a good board from Bossier, though.
Oh, almost had the. There you got the steal. Nelson, number 5, is a really pesky defender. He's a really good defender. Knows how to get steals. Knows how to get his hand in there. I think him and number 7, I think, are a good matchup for each other.
It's really interesting. There's a lot of good scorers on the Durham team.
Mm-hmm.
10-minute quarters. Nelson Maxwell has 14 points per game.
Okay.
You know, and that's only good enough for third.
Right, yeah. You know. And that's a good offensive team right there. Yeah.
And so what's that?
That was just a foul on the ground. So,
okay, so
on the floor.
You're going to have to keep me straight with the fouls.
Yep, so...
My sport's a little bit rougher, so I didn't quite get that one.
So that was Newcastle's second team foul on the floor. So since he wasn't shooting it, they just get the ball. They
just
get the ball back.
He blocked him.
Yeah, yeah, pretty much. Yep, he reached in, made contact with Chris, foul.
And is there a limit to individual fouls before you have to...
Yep, 5. 5 fouls. The rebound. So there's a shooting foul. So now Sue will get two shots.
Two for this.
Yep.
And if it had gone in, he would have just got one.
Yep.
See, I'm rolling it back to like NBA Jam.
Yeah, yeah.
Figure it out.
That's why, you know, if you make the basket and you get fouled, people always yell, "And one!" Because then they get the one shot after.
Training company.
Right, exactly, yeah. Yeah, that did use, yeah, and one was big back in the day.
You had the mixtapes, didn't you?
Yep.
James, can you check the stream? Is it okay? My laptop's, so I can't change it. So, in the timeout, which way was this one called? Timeout, was it? You see?
What was it?
Which one? Whose timeout was it?
I believe Newcastle. So.
And what situations would you take a timeout for? Just want to slow it down?
Yeah. I think he could sense that Durham was gaining some momentum. He just wanted to regroup and kind of maybe go over their next offensive play that they want to run.
Now, quite interesting. Oh, no, he's coming back on. I thought Nico Uli was off there. So we're still with all starters out on the court at the minute.
Right. Yeah, 15, what's his name?
Nico Uli.
Early, yeah. He's got most of their all their points, or four of their points?
Yeah, so I think we had number 9, David Labossiere on the steal and the dunk.
Nice, good rebound, Chris. Good shot, nice. Nice shot.
Any chance that's anywhere near intentional?
Which one? Oh, the miss on the free throw. Yeah, exactly. That was definitely on purpose.
The rim,
yep.
For free.
Yep.
That's nice.
That's what they talked about in the timeout, probably.
12-6, you just see the number 7, the guard is busy, but he seems like ahead of his teammates.
Yeah, yeah. Nice. Shot clock violation.
Timeout. And so we're going to see Stanokovic. Is that how you
pronounce it? They're going to put you from the ball pressure.
For us. Mitar. I'm not sure on the last names. I just know the first names. Yeah, Mitar is a huge part of their team, too.
It's brilliant to bring the sixth player off the bench. Right. And not really lose anything and actually gain a bit of, a little bit of a stylistic difference.
Oh,
a bit
definitely.
More size under the rim. You already see him using it here.
Yep. Nice move. Oh. Two.
Good shot there by Massive. Good open look. Yeah. Disappointed to miss that one.
Yeah. I like it when good cut. Wow. I like it when Mitar and Sue, 8 and 13, are in there together. I think it's so nice to have like two bigs that can play inside and outside.
Yeah. And actually we saw Winkowski Joel be much more inside. It's almost like as soon as there were two bigs on, he kind of flexed in and went as the third big as well and played that more traditional center, power forward, small forward.
Yeah,
kind of,
definitely.
Kind of look. So interesting talking basketball to some of our scholars that have come over who've been through the high school system, they've been through the college system, and a lot of our exposure is NBA.
Right,
so we're used to that three bigs.
Okay.
7 foot, 300 pounds.
Right,
post play. So it's quite interesting to see more of the high school style, college style, zone defense.
Yep.
And see these teams with it with 3-4 guards.
For sure. Nice pass! Oh my gosh. He passed that between his legs.
Yeah, kind of an easy put down just because of the assist.
Wow.
It's unbelievable. Exciting playing with a player like Chris Jones.
Definitely.
All those options get turned on.
Yep.
Everybody's facing him.
Everyone's
saying, okay, what are you going to do next?
Exactly.
The ball was off Labossiere. The ball has gone into the stands.
Yeah, I think if you're Chris's teammate, you always have to be ready to catch the ball because he's always looking to get the open player the ball, which is like a fun teammate to play with.
So we're going into the last 3 minutes of this quarter. Really good start so far from Durham with a lead 14-7. Newcastle University have played quite well on transition and steals and things like that, but they've not been able to build any good shots and any good pressure, really.
Mm-hmm.
Well, here they go, they've got the hands on the ball and a chance to set it up.
Charge. Nice. Offensive foul.
A lost possession there.
Yep.
As you can see, the American football team.
I was going to say, those look like some of your players over there.
Absolutely. simplifying it for a bit more. You can't do it.
Yep.
And again with the Imperial March. I'm loving this.
Good take. Nice take. And one. And one. Now we can say it.
Tara Finley with the actually, this is huge here because the Amwon gives them a chance for the to open
the three-point
play. Digit lead.
Yep. Newcastle timeout again.
Yeah, and you can actually see the body language is a bit different.
Yeah, definitely.
Down. You've been beaten twice in the regular season. You're not the favourite. Someone said, it's a game that can go either way, but already the bench, the head's down a little bit, and Durham just have so much momentum at the end of this first quarter that they really want to put this game away.
Right, and Durham comes at you with so many players. Like you said, they can all score the ball. You know, I'm pretty sure almost everyone on the court has scored, one basket already, and that's really, really tough to guard. It just wears teams down, and obviously it's frustrating Newcastle, so.
But it's one of those games where hitting your next three shots can change everything, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, for sure. It's still like a close game, but Durham, with their past couple takes to the basket, I think they're definitely getting the momentum now. Good shot, Tanner. Durham staying with the press. Durham staying with the full court press. Just a little bit of pressure.
It's interesting. Why does the team do that?
What's that?
Why does the team do that?
You know? Yeah, I think maybe if the team doesn't have... Oh, good shot. That was a nice shot.
There you go. You were the ball lovely, and Tom Horford knocks down the
point. Yeah. You can tell he's a shooter.
It was a very smooth shot.
Yeah. There we go. Foul. No, yeah, I think teams can press to if they think that they have an advantage with their guards, if they want to put pressure on their guards to get some steals, they can do it to tire team out if they don't think they have a lot of depth on the bench. And I think Durham is a good team to press because they do have so many quick guards who can get steals.
And so was that one there given as a shooting foul because he had his hands in the air when he reached in?
So that was a...
Is that the fifth foul already?
Oh, so do the men have the same rules as us? Five fouls shooting one and one. Or shooting two, I mean. They must. I'm embarrassed that I don't know this. So I think they must have the same rules as us because that was not a shooting foul. So it's two foul shots at five fouls.
Okay.
Five team fouls. So since that was their fifth, he got to shoot.
And so is that a standard NCAA rule or is that an international IFBB rule?
So I, for women, I know they changed that rule within the past maybe 3 years. For men, I believe it must be recent as well. I think the NBA might be different though.
Yeah, the NBA is different.
Yeah.
I'm sure it's
six. Yeah, yeah.
Unbelievable.
Good steal.
So that is huge.
Nice kick. Nice shot.
You had Newcastle on the board. Looked like a great steal, quick transition.
Yeah.
Jones pulls it straight back.
Yeah.
Maxwell knocks it down. 22-10. Probably going to get two or three shots left this this quarter.
Mm-hmm.
The boss here knocks down his jumper.
That was a big shot. Cut it to 10. Cut it to 10 before the quarter ends.
And it means that they were quick enough, so they are going to get the ball again.
Oh, I thought he was going to shoot it. Foul. Good.
And so in terms of the fouls, does this last the half now or just the quarter?
Just the quarter. Yep. All the fouls will reset after this.
So Lepossier leaves the court and they bring back on Nico Early, a big physical post player. Number 5, Colizel Lewis has entered the court.
Number 5,
well.
Yep. There we go. How much? 17 seconds left, so I'm guessing Newcastle might hold the ball for the last shot of this quarter.
Especially, you know, if this one goes in and you're looking at a 12-point lead, you've got to hope to cut that to 9.
Right.
Hobart isn't on the court, though, so it'll be interesting to see who's the shooter.
Yeah. Good defense. 3, 2, 1. Ooh! Chris wanted to foul. Yeah.
A 2 minute change. Newcastle 12, the double digit lead. Been a smooth start so far. What do Newcastle have to do to get back in the game?
I see that. I think they've got to get number 7 more shots. I think he only took about one shot that quarter. And if he's one of their main scorers, I think he's got to get more involved. And their post player. Yeah, he had a great start. I think they have to get him more touches as well.
Nicely from Newcastle so far, 15 early, 9 Lavoisier, and 7 Horvath have kind of been everything so far.
Yeah.
Whereas you go across to Durham and actually all 5, if
right.
not 6 players that have done something, contributed.
Yep.
So Newcastle probably need a few more people just to get them in.
Right. I think defensively Newcastle has to do a better job of just containing Durham's drives as well. I think Durham gets to the basket really well. So I think that's something that they'll want to focus on defense. And Ryan checked in for Durham, number 6.
Pardon?
Ryan checked in for Durham, 6, and he's another pure shooter for Durham. He can just knock down the 3. So that's another thing Newcastle has to think about.
He's only a second year.
Yeah.
You know, so he's doing a sports science course. He's got this year, he's got the following year at least, maybe more.
Yeah.
You know?
And I think Ryan's one of those guys where when he gets his shot going, that really motivates the whole team. The team gets really excited for him. So it'll be fun to see if he can get some shots up in this quarter.
He always is a bit of a stigma. He is the smallest player on both
yep.
on both teams. But I guess it's one of those, you know, super cliches. What he lacks in stature,
right.
makes up for in heart and energy.
Exactly. It's not how small you are. Or no, it's not how big you are. It's how big you play.
Yeah.
Good shot. Oh.
Great board goal from Masu.
Ooh, pretty.
Okay, so it's interesting straight away to see number 5 for Newcastle on the ball.
Oh, good take. Oh, we missed it. There we go.
But he was under great pressure from Ryan.
Yeah, that was good defense, good recovery.
Good strength from Massey to keep that ball alive.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, very nice. So I'm looking there with
the reflection.
The body fake was lovely.
Oh, Tanner tried to take a charge there. Good defense.
Masu had time to check his form is okay and then start the transition.
Yep. Ian, the coach Ian's kind of telling him to slow it down, slow it down a little bit.
He does really feel right now with a 14-point lead that they can, you know, this is the moment to put it on
definitely.
And put this game away a little bit.
Yep. You want to for sure take advantage of when you have the momentum in the game and not let Newcastle cut it any more than this.
It's a great shooting lineup that's on the court. I mean, okay, Chris isn't out there. You lose a little bit of handles. You lose a little bit in transition.
Yep.
But you've got five shooters out there.
Definitely. Oh. That's what Newcastle needed was a stop right there.
Yeah, and that is the thing that Chris would have brought as well, though, wouldn't he? You know, that game management.
Definitely.
That veteran head.
Right.
And we see Horvat back on court now.
Oh, there he is again. Yep. Durham's got to be sure to box him out on the rebounds.
How much energy does that take in the long term
game?
A
lot.
The hardest part of the game?
Definitely, yep. And the more tired you get, the harder it is. Oh, good shot.
And Horvath's busy again, and he's a very, very smooth player. He looks like he definitely will.
Dice steal. There we go. There we go.
Crowd loved that one.
Yeah. I think the team feeds off Ryan's energy for sure, so I think that'll spark Durham a little more. Oh, good cut. Nice defense. Oh, foul.
A little bit of frustration creeping in there from Nelson Maxwell. Doesn't agree with the call.
Yeah, he thought he got it clean.
Is that giving us holding? Is that like...
Yeah, pretty much.
The arm.
Yeah. Good defense. They only have 5 seconds. Oh, barely gets it in. Yeah, now that Chris is back in the game, I think they'll be a little more organized on offense.
And it's just that rhythm. Isn't
oh, good. Oh, good follow.
A little miscommunication with Marcel.
Good cut. That was a good cut to the basket and a good pass.
Quite interesting talking to Newcastle pre-game, and you definitely identified, you know, some of their key players. But every single person mentioned the player who just scored there, Joe Schiavelli. And
okay.
It's just like, with that, you know, a smile on your face, makes you think, okay, this is a good dude who works hard for the team. He's a sixth or seventh off the bench. It's nice to see him contributing early on.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah, and just like that, they've cut it to 12, so that was a good cut. And a lot of, I noticed, I think the number 15 passed him that ball. I think a lot of their offense is going through him. Either he's making the pass or he's scoring.
Super direct, wasn't it? It was just, he's the hammer, let's go. And now actually they're starting to say, okay, against Masu, it's a bit of a tough matchup.
Yeah.
So let's move you, because, you know, the question about, I guess, about Durham's team is, do they have a second Masu?
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you can tire him out, who's next?
Right.
And obviously, Mitar does a pretty good job
Mitar.
In there. But as we said, it's always best when it's Mitar and Masu at the same
time. Yeah, and they're both in there now, so that'll be good.
with just over 6 minutes of Q2 remains, it is with Chris Jones.
And you can see that even though the action's heating up, the American football coaches have just walked in casually, partway through the quarter.
Fashionably late. Good take.
Oh, just a long shot. Bossier as well, so cover that one. Newcastle go to build. And the coach is animated for the first time, which is nice to see. Coach Mark Elderkin gives a very clear instruction. Let's see if we can work a shot here. And one
right there.
Yeah, I got it. So this could cut it down. Wait, divided it up. Ooh, no, this could cut it down to 9.
Yeah, that was a big basket right there.
This has been a big 8 for the game, really, so far, hasn't it? The start of this quarter has been
crazy. Yep.
And actually, you can see here again, Coach Mark Elkin is animated, he's communicating crystal clear. You've got a great look with over. And actually, the bench is lifting a little bit more.
Right. Yeah, Durham's got to be sure to stop this run because Newcastle's starting to heat up. Here we go. Durham will work the ball around. I think they'll get one on this possession. They know this is a big possession.
And one thing they're certainly going to do is take at least 20 seconds out of it. They're not going to make sure that this run is over quick.
Yep. Oh, out of bounds.
How difficult is it to play on a court with multiple lines on?
It is very difficult. Especially the sidelines. Yeah, it's really tough. There he is again.
And we've got an 8-point game.
Yeah, cut it to 8.
That's a great run to start that second quarter.
Yeah. Nice take.
It's always important. You know, Nico Early just put a little move on him and got 2 points. And come straight back.
Right, they've got a good battle going on.
I can do it.
Yep. Nice defense. Good pass. Oh, unlucky.
I would like that one back.
Yeah, yep.
You get own buckets.
You know, I think that's a great question.
I think
they give the point to 12. Yeah.
Dubious goals committee and all that.
Right. Oh my gosh. There we go. Oh.
He's got to get his head in his meat off.
Oh, good shot. So 24-30 now. Yeah. Durham's got to find their rhythm back a little bit. Newcastle's been scoring more. They've had less transition, where I think that's where they get a lot of their energy from, is those transition baskets.
I guess as sort of strategist, it's a tough decision to make, isn't it? Because you're playing well in transition, but you've got a double-digit lead.
Right, right.
So if you keep speeding the game up, they've got more shots.
Right, yeah.
But so you choose to slow it down a little bit, and you get out your rhythm. It's tough.
Yeah. That's always a good way to stop momentum when Newcastle has it going. For Sue to get a foul, that's a good way to stop the game. You know, take a break, catch your breath. He can come out of this timeout, hit his free throws, and then hopefully they'll have the momentum back.
Celebrating the success of Durham University here at your Sports and Learning Park.
Durham was 2 free throws. Shooting a foul on, was it on Massu?
Yes. Yeah. Yep.
So I think this is his third trip to the line, is it? I think so. 3 or 4 so far.
He's good at drawing fouls toward him. He gets to the free throw line a lot. Oh, was it on the floor?
Oh, yeah, it must
have. Oh, I guess it was on the floor foul.
Fix it round. Jones goes from outside the arc. What's it? Big rebound inside.
Get in. There we go.
It's kindly from Matthew. Put back and
they needed that one.
They absolutely did. And an 8-point game. Roberts on the ball. He's always looking for that incisive pass.
Yeah, Newcastle's gotten a lot of second chance points off the offensive rebounds.
They've definitely had an improvement in that energy and effort and hustle.
Yeah, definitely.
Actually, they're going to try and match it, but a little bit too much fight there.
Yeah. That was a great shot by Tanner. When Tanner heats up, he's tough to stop too.
Yeah, I know in the comments of the last game, a lot of people were talking about it, very excited by.
Yeah. Good all around player.
So far for Newcastle, this lineup that's on court has been the most productive. All the players we've talked about are really out there and performing. It's a big miss and a good transition here.
Good kick. Nelson. Oh. Great shot. Great pass. Great shot. Right.
A little bit of, I don't know, I guess it's not doubt, is it? It's just a little bit of tension in the air as well. People keep missing. Three on the clock. Tanner under pressure.
There we go.
15 second clock.
Chris. Oh. They're getting open shots, you know.
They're just not falling for them.
Yeah.
Tanner gets a great rebound. Easy, simple transition. Durham slow it down a touch.
Nice pass. Good finish. There we go.
We haven't seen much number four so far. Valentin Bado from Nantes. He's been playing really well, apparently, and he was one of the ones to look out for. So,
okay.
Newcastle are going to close this gap. I think it's this five that are on four.
Yeah.
And we need to see just a touch more from number four.
There it is.
Yep.
That'll do a lot for Durham to see one go through the hoop.
Yeah,
I think that'll get him going.
A double digit lead again. We're at 11 points, 46 seconds.
Hopefully, we can keep this lead going into halftime.
I presume that's a pretty good foul to take. It's not shots, there's 30
yeah, not
seconds
bad.
Left. We're not at the foul line.
Here comes. Good rebound.
Winkowski, Joel Winkowski before leaning back, reaches it out.
Newcastle's in a zone defense right now.
So is that like a 2-3?
Yep, 2-3, so they're going to try to force Durham to hit some outside shots. Which they do. Nice. Great shot.
Right,
yeah, that was a great finish.
Had a three from Winkowski, and that's a 14-point game at the half. Durham 40, Newcastle 26. We're going to take a little break here. On the court, you're going to see a lot of our teams who've made the final BUCS Big Wednesday. Obviously, there's a political thing at the minute, a health thing with the coronavirus.
Yeah.
All sport is, I guess, at least at risk. It's really interesting to see the performance of Durham this year, where there's been 11 teams make national finals.
Wow.
Another three teams make trophy finals. And all those teams are going to be invited up on court, be shouted out. So we're going to take a little break in the commentary. The screen's going to see all our successful teams here rocking their new Road to the Final shirts.
Yeah, those are awesome.
You got a nice warm-up shirt for Glasgow?
No, you know, I don't think we did. I don't think we got one.
Man,
I'm going to have to get one of those, though.
You're going to have to get on Lee's case and get some
those look nice.
Shirts made up. Okay, so we're going to take a little break now, and we'll be back with you in about 5 minutes.
Sounds good.
Okay, we're back here with about 30 seconds to go to the second half. Durham 40, Newcastle 26. Hopefully you enjoyed those scenes at halftime where several of our athletes were out on court. We have currently 11 teams in national finals. Hopefully another one tonight, hopefully another one Sunday. Our women's professional team, we've got the cup final Sunday. Is that on the BBC?
Yep. Yeah, should be on BBC.
BBC, is it on the iPlayer or the red button or BBC Two or?
Oh gosh, it's either.
Well, now's your chance.
Maybe the red button, BBC red button, or no, maybe BBC Sport. Oh gosh.
iPlayer for sure. You'll be able to watch it online. And Durham start with possession here, and they're back in the smooth style, moving the ball around, not too much pressure being applied.
Nice pass. Good shot. Oh, in and out.
And here we go again.
Second chance.
Seconds. Oh,
beautiful. Yeah.
Putting it on the post player. Easy assist, and Winkowski knocks it down.
Yeah. Joel, number 4 for Durham, is just a machine. He just works hard every possession. Oh, good pass.
I've only seen a few games, but I don't think there's any player on the Durham team you couldn't say that.
Oh, you're right. They all work extremely hard. Crash the boards.
Yeah. I was kind of, a little bit thinking, oh, I wonder if they lost tonight, would they all come out for football? But looks like not.
Nice take.
Good inside move from Massey. And again, showing the range of the team, hard inside move. End of 4, easy shots, good follow-ups.
Mm.
Oh, and that's an early foul there. And
that's his third foul,
that's
too.
His third, okay, so that's what the paddle's about.
Yeah.
Okay, so he's going to have to. Has he been off the court yet? Has Nelson been off the court?
In the first half? Yeah, he sat a little bit. But Coach Ian's trusting him to stay in. He knows he's a smart player. He won't get another one. Good defense. Oh no! Unlucky. That was so unlucky. It was a 2. Yeah. It was great defense.
He just. It's kind of a new foul in the NBA, isn't it? Where they're stepping into the landing zone.
Yeah, kind of. You gotta let him land.
Didn't make any contact on the ball.
Right.
Landed in the zone. He was gonna land.
Yeah, pretty much. It was
James Harden who's been like manufacturing
those. Oh my gosh! Yeah, it's like. Defense is great. You can play perfect defense, and then if they land, boom, foul.
Okay, so still a 15-point lead here for Durham. And you can just see as they build this these attacks and this pressure, it's very calm, very smooth. They're going to use most of the shot clock here. Knocks it down, nice and smooth, but it won't count because they've got a foul on the floor first. And actually, we're only 2 minutes gone. It's, 3 fouls already. It's going to be a quarter where this matters.
They love this song. They love the music here. Good shot, Sue.
Very nice.
Sue's having a solid game.
Yeah, Masu was looking for a little bit of eye contact there with early. Just saying, don't stand off me.
Right.
I'll knock it down. I think my favorite phrase is posterizing. I'm hoping to be able to use it tonight.
You'll have to wait for the right moment. Yeah.
I'm going
to
go early.
Good pass. Oh, beautiful. Yes, I think that should have been an and one. 2 good passes, good finish.
That's the lead stretching to 19, which is the biggest lead in the game so far.
Yep.
A couple of quick buckets. And actually the transition there, we talked about it early.
Yeah, coming up huge.
Extremely smooth.
Yeah.
Extremely efficient.
This is a really important timeout for Newcastle if they want to stay in this game, too. My teammates are lined up in the front, enjoying the game.
Certainly enjoying the
dark fruits that's on offer.
That too. Definitely.
A little bit of R&R.
Yes, the timeout ends with 48 and 29, 19-point lead, the biggest it's been all day.
If you were the coach for Newcastle, got any ideas?
The coach for Newcastle?
Yeah.
Any ideas of what to do? Oh, man. I mean, I think defensively, you just got to try to stop their transition. Get back right away, match up right away to try to slow Durham down. Other than that, yeah, I'd go back inside, like how they were doing at the start. There's a quick foul. Mitar.
And so what was that foul?
Just, I think, too many hands on him. Yeah, yep. Too physical. Kind of wrapped him up.
Because it seems at times there's actually brutal contact, and then other times nothing contact.
Right, yeah.
And obviously there is a difference. But
definitely. Yeah, that's good defense.
Especially after picking up the foul, it's quite easy to become hesitant and not go in there, not stand
right.
strong. But it's beginning, it's a turnover for Durham.
Durham, they're going to look for Sue now. Oh. He thought it was clean. They got a foul.
And obviously a little bit of frustration there from Newcastle because it's given us a shooting foul, so Massey has a chance to take us up to 50 here. Williams goes back to ground, drops good on 20 point lead for the first time in the game.
Good shot.
Oh, they've even got a funny sound for it. Really quite interestingly, you know, his school is listed as his high school.
Oh, okay.
Side on academy. And he's an undergrad.
So he's younger, okay.
Strategy to have Scholar over here for several years.
Right. Especially one with his height.
Yeah, 6'8".
Yeah.
He looks a touch light for his frame at the minute compared to the other players on the
court. Right.
But you've probably got time to pull that out.
Yeah. Speaking of young players, fresher. Jasper.
He's a first year.
Yeah. He's fun to watch. Yeah. Really fun to watch.
Jasper. It's been a difficult matchup against the Bossier. He's clearly strong, well-conditioned athlete.
Good pass, good finish. Oh, Sue's getting into that. you could nearly almost use your word too soon. It's gonna be a better one.
I think they've got to be.
Yeah, definitely. You're right.
Oh.
Yep, that's a foul.
Okay, so we're still at Durham 54, Newcastle 29. We've got a 25-point lead here, and Ian McDonald misses his first free throw, but he gets another attempt.
Misses both. Oh. Yep. That's where you get a little tired. It's hard to remember to box out sometimes.
You can see straight away. It's just like looking at the Newcastle team. It's been waves of emotion.
Mm-hmm.
It's been up. It's been down. The heads have gone. They've come back. A moment like that where you know a young player comes and makes a play.
Oh. Oh, foul on Newcastle.
That's huge,
yeah. He's got two.
Because that just takes the second shot away as well.
Right, yeah.
But it was and one, wasn't it? He made the first.
Yeah,
one.
Yeah.
Durham at five team fouls with 6 minutes left to go.
Yeah, so Newcastle's shooting now for the rest of the quarter. Oh, shoot it. Oh. Durham is so unselfish. They always pass up a good shot for a better shot. Oh.
Like Horvath's play, but he definitely enjoys more no-look passes than his team. You know? When you're in a 2v1 transition and everyone knows where you're passing, it's, you know, it's a little bit too much sauce, I think.
Too much sauce. See, I'm all for the sauce. Yeah, no such thing as too much sauce.
A 2-on-1.
Why not? Why not? Make it a little exciting.
You know where the ball's going. Which you've always got to be looking at that highlight tape, haven't you?
Right, exactly. Good shot.
Gets on the board. He's had a difficult quarter so far. He's been a bit
He's been a little more quiet, yeah.
He's asked for a few fouls that he's not got, but he brings a good shot there.
There. You could. No, not good enough. Okay.
Down on the floor.
Okay. Right, okay.
You know, I want to say, I think, you know, it's almost got to be a technical for it to count for me.
Oh, okay, okay. Good defense. Oh my gosh, what a pass. That's those lines over there. Those lines on the other side, it is really, it's tough. Right. And so when you see it out of the corner of your eye, you think you're in bounds.
I think in the future we are planning for games, certainly this magnitude, to get a parquet floor. And,
oh, good.
And have a clean look on
yeah. That'll be helpful.
And that'll be the thing that takes it to the next level.
Yep. Oh, gosh. Good defense by Chris there.
Yeah.
Durham finally recovers
I think he was mainly annoyed that the
good skip.
The legs put back assist.
Right, yeah.
You know, that he passed it.
Right.
He wanted that assist.
Yeah, for sure.
Do you count plus one assists in, like, in hockey, or?
Is that like the pass before the assist?
Exactly, yeah.
No, nope. 13. How many does Mitar have? He's got 3.
Yeah. And we're into the shots already.
Yep.
And actually, I'm not sure I've seen Valentin Badu score yet. And we've been asking him, when's he getting into the game? Mm-hmm. We know he's a highly rated player. And here's a chance to start getting on the board.
Yep. That's
We've got a 21-point game here, and it looks an attempt by Chris to slow it down a bit.
Oh, good pass.
Play with a little bit more pace now, Newcastle moving the ball quickly. Oh. Unfortunate there to mishandle it.
Yeah. I feel like both teams are kind of playing a little tired right now.
Yeah, here comes Shabelli, who actually, the best period of the game, he was on the ball a bit.
Yeah, he had it going.
A few assists.
Newcastle's back to a zone, it looks like. Like a 1-2-2 or a 3-2. Nice cut. Good. Good hustle. There we go. Mitar is frustrated. He wanted the and one for that one.
Yeah.
That was a good
Chris
take, though.
Jones, as always, wanted the assist as well.
Yeah, of course.
Assist
yeah.
Just got out of the first one.
Both teams missing some free throws here at the end of this quarter. There we go.
So the lead isn't really growing. It's settled for the last sort of 5 minutes of the game. And obviously that just suits Durham as the time ebbs away here. Overall with a good move. Oh, Massey was on the board. It looked initially like Hurley was going to come down with it, but Massey was just outpowering it.
Good take, good pass. There we go. Oh. That was a nice shot. That was a really nice shot.
Him or Early.
Right.
Well, Early seems to have faded.
Yeah, a little bit. I think if they want to get back into this game, he's got to hit some more of those. Oh, right back at him, though. Oh, nice. Yep.
Shot and assist there.
They got seven left, six, five, good take. Nice.
1 minute left in the third quarter, 22-point lead. Big transition.
Wow. He did like five shot fakes and then shot it.
You're not a fan? Or are you a big fan?
It works, so it works. So I'm a fan.
Okay. Anything that drops works.
Exactly.
Yeah, Chris Jones, really quick in transition, cancels out the quintuple shot pump fake.
Oh, good shot! He has it going now. Newcastle's getting into their rhythm.
The coach again,
Yeah, definitely. Definitely a spark. Right back at him, Sue. Oh, good try. 3-2.
Let's go. Durham 64, Newcastle 45, 19-point lead.
Yeah.
And it's not as bad as it was. It got to about 24, didn't it? So
right. Durham got a little tired at the end there. Newcastle definitely took advantage. Yeah, if Newcastle can keep that pace going, they can chip away at this lead, you know, but I think with the start of the new quarter, I think Durham will get back to their scoring ways. Oh my gosh, David's checking in. So David is coming off of a Achilles injury.
Was it first practice or first game?
I think first game. First game, yeah.
I know he had an Achilles problem, and it's been a big miss all year, but really excited to see him back on.
Yeah, for sure. I'm excited to watch him play.
And actually, the five that are out there, Maxwell, Winkowski, Massey Williams, Tanner Finley, and David Howard. It's a powerful five just late in the game.
Yeah.
And actually, Newcastle might have their best five of the day out. Chiavelli on the ball here, to Hobart's done really well.
Good defense. Ooh. Tough call.
Two shots.
The fans are really getting into it now. They like these free throws, trying to make them miss.
And unfortunately, it's my boys. As always.
As usual.
That's a great pass.
Good take. Ooh, nice. David gets right to it. He gets right to it. Gets right to the free throw line. Yep.
Great contact with the court. Yeah, it looks like he's not missed a beat.
Yeah. Good for him. That's got to feel amazing to get back on the court, especially in a semifinal game.
And it's such a boost heading into the finals.
Yeah. Good shot.
Especially with that smooth shot. And
yep.
He's going to drop him from the line and he's going to play physical. That's mm-hmm. the type of thing that wins finals.
Yep.
Finding that extra player that, you know, has been a huge boost.
Nice. 2 for 2. Oh. Cha-ching, I like that.
Get that on Sunday.
Yeah, definitely. I like that. Nelson's got to be careful.
Good job.
Oh wow.
David Bossier coming up from Connecticut College.
Okay. Nice skip pass. Nice.
What a way to answer. Great handles from Newcastle. Good inside work, but Winkowski very smooth with a 3-pointer, restores the 20-point lead. Durham 69, yeah. Newcastle 49.
Newcastle put a little
Sue's got to have a double-double with rebounds.
Yeah,
I feel like he's grabbing nice everything. Good shot, Tanner. Another one.
Nine rebounds. Yeah. In double figures for points.
Yeah.
Did he just grab that defensive board then?
Yeah.
Okay, so he has got the double-double.
Oof. That was a good cut.
That's a nice pass.
Yep. Good cut, good pass. That help defense has to get over there. Just a second faster. Nice kick. Another one. He's feeling it. Tanner's feeling it. There it is. Yeah. Yeah, when he heats up, it's dangerous. Like,
so 6 out of 7 from the 3-point zone.
Is he?
Tonight, yeah.
Wow.
That's at least 18 points, and I'm pretty sure he would have picked up something inside.
Oh, in and out. That's the worst.
Doesn't it work?
Yeah.
Oh,
good fake.
Again, and with 6 minutes 30 seconds to go, with a 24-point lead for Durham, 75, Newcastle 51.
Nice pass. Nice. You wanted him to dunk that one.
I did.
Yeah.
I did.
It's all right. We'll take the 2 points. Take the 2 points. Oh.
So yeah, the same masses on 9 boards in the minute.
Rebound powers down. Maxwell thought about it, pulls it back. Some great ball skills.
Ooh.
Foul call on the dribble.
There we go. great to see our coach of Durham on. They're feeling pretty comfortable right now.
Oh, yeah.
On faces.
Yeah.
And I think actually the stint from David and Howard is really boosting them.
Yeah,
as well.
Geez.
It must be so frustrating to come over here all the way from the States.
Oh, for sure.
Hurt your ankle, your Achilles early on.
Yeah.
Watch your whole season. Stay in shape.
Mm-hmm.
And then actually to come on and contribute again.
Yeah.
It must be a real big thanks.
Yeah. But obviously all of his hours in the weight room doing rehab have paid off, because he looks comfortable out there now, really quick and hit some shots.
He looks fresh, he looks mean.
Definitely. That's exciting. That's really exciting for Durham going into the finals, like you said. I got to give a shout out to my teammate Kara, who plays on Durham with me, but her husband is the coach, Mark, of the Newcastle team.
Okay.
I had to tell her that she has to cheer for Durham tonight.
So she got split.
I think she's split. Nice play. Oh, I thought he was gonna shoot it. They got 5 seconds. He's gonna have to pull it. Oh.
Way beyond the pro line.
Yeah, that was a deep shot. Yeah.
Newcastle 51, 26-point lead. Again, it's at that sort of level where it's the most it's been all day.
Mm-hmm. I like that matchup.
Yeah.
That's a good matchup to watch. Two bigs battling in the post. Good shot, Nelson. Another three.
Bench gets up a little bit for Durham there.
Yeah.
Pretty excited here. The final 5 minutes. Durham 80, Newcastle 51. And Durham really will be starting to think about that final. And if they play like this, they'll be tough to beat.
Yeah, for sure. Oh.
Recycle again. Open shot, Winkowski.
Just short.
He's been really good from beyond the arc today.
Yeah. The crowd's getting excited for Jasper and Ryan checking back in too.
It's good to see that there's that knowledge there, where there's that, you know, those young guys playing. It means a lot to people.
Nice move.
And I think you know, worldwide, countrywide, Durham has a reputation of obviously having excellent sports teams,
mm-hmm.
but. You know, the scholarship model, etc.
Yeah.
Seeing young people.
Oh, yeah.
And learning the craft. Playing as a team, it's playing as equals. It's really fantastic.
Nice pass. Yeah, I think it's cool. And it really shows how unselfish and supportive the guys are on the team of each other, because they get so hyped for each other as well. Oh, good cut, good pass, yeah.
That's one of the first times. We have seen him in the game earlier, but Corazon Lewis gets a nice bucket right on. Nice pass.
Oh, nice. Nice.
Definitely at least 20 points there. We know he's got six from outside. He's definitely got that one.
Yeah. There, Chris just fouled so that they could get the subs in. That's awesome.
Number six, Ryan Harris. Second year from Hartlepool. Number seven, Jasper Ladd. First year from Itchen. Young guys out on court playing ball.
Yeah. I feel like most of Durham's points tonight, I feel like came off of assists. Just all good passes and working with each other. It's rarely just one-on-one. They work so well together. Oh, good move.
Ian McDonald, a nice move inside, but it doesn't quite drop for him. And we have Maxwell on the transition. Distributing the ball around.
Oh,
Durham probably playing the smallest team of the night at the moment. And Newcastle have got a player in the game we've not seen too much of, Matthew Tomlinson.
Good shot.
I think this place is going to go crazy if we see Ryan or Josh.
Oh, yeah. Yep. There it is. Oh, just short.
With a great effort to try and keep it in, but doesn't quite. And Newcastle inbound this with just under 2 minutes to go. 27-point lead here. The game's not in doubt anymore, but Newcastle be playing for those final points to make that shot. Another player we've not seen too much of from Newcastle, so he's shout out Nadeem Abdu Ramadan.
Oh.
Another undergrad, which is promising for Newcastle. So Matthew Tomlinson 13, Ramadan 8, both undergrads. Roberto Sessi was undergrad as well, number 10. Looks like another player is going to enter the game as well, another undergrad. Kwame Selleck-Cole, next time there's a break. Really great to see the young players out on court performing at this level.
Yeah. Oh!
You can almost see that Chris is trying to set his boys up as well.
For sure. There it is. There it is.
See the crowd goes crazy. Do a big
yep.
Nose tackle for the American football team. The crowd going crazy. We're inside the final 16. And the clock is at 53 seconds, going down as Conzo Lewis brings the ball out. Matthew Tomlinson drives in, puts up the floater, but it doesn't drop. Lying in the transition, and you just got to feel that this team's going to be looking for Jasper Ladd. Trying to open up the shot here for number 7, he's in the far corner.
Oh, Mitar will try a 3.
Mitar takes it.
Oh, in and out. Nice steal. Yeah, there. He'll look for Jasper. There we go. The crowd loves it. Yes, yep. He'll get 2 free throws. Chance to get on the board.
59 Newcastle. They're going to be going crazy if he's going. The crowd's being shushed. The American football team are on the feet.
They love to see it.
Kyron McKinney Cuddy in the crowd is about to go off.
Oh! He'll get this one.
Guys, what they want.
They're encouraging him. He'll put this one in. It's a lot of pressure out there, you know? Short. Oh, he wanted it. He wanted it.
That's tough for the young man. Comes down. Wait for the final clock. He looks disappointed.
Yeah.
That's the high standards he set. He's absolutely proud of him.
Oh, for sure. So yep.
Everyone on both sides should be brought a higher, energetic game plan. We played every single player on the team. They got through 10 people really early.
Yeah.
Durham stuck to the game plan with a big 5 or 6 players for most of the game. But they put it away comfortably, and that's the 12th Durham team heading to a national final.
Yeah, how exciting, honestly. I think this is a great game to go into a finals off of. They played well. Everybody did their thing. Should be a good final. And hats off to Newcastle, too. They played a great game. It was really fun to watch.
Okay, so you gonna get it done on Sunday?
Am I? Oh yeah, yeah.
Yeah, you winning this one?
We got it. We have to.
Well, best of luck for Sunday. We're getting done against Birmingham. I think that's gonna be us at the end here. Thanks for joining us at Newcastle. Durham 86, Newcastle 59, and Durham University go to the national final game at Big Wednesday. Thank you very much.